The last thing I want to say, Mr. Speaker, is that we've achieved a lot, but there is a threat that is going to affect this house. This BBI, Mr. Speaker. This BBI is going to, Mr. Speaker, take away the gains we have achieved in that judgment. And particularly, Mr. Speaker, when it comes to the touching of Article 123 in terms of decision of this House, where, Mr. Speaker, the people of Kenya already decided that decisions of this House, Mr. Speaker, must be passed by at least a half of the counties, not just the individuals sitting in this House of the counties. And, Mr. Speaker, we must be vigilant. I saw in the media Senator Orengo and members of the lower house saying this document cannot be opened. It must go as it is. I hope, Mr. Speaker, it was a misrepresentation of facts. This document, Mr. Speaker, must be opened, must be discussed. We must, Mr. Speaker, change those sections. How can you tell me, Mr. Speaker, that Article 218 that talks about division of revenue, Mr. Speaker, shall be vetoed by the National Assembly? And at the same time tell us that 35% of the money will go to counties. Mr. Speaker, the president, if you get a president who is Amjeuri, Mr. Speaker, the president will say, I can't be able to allocate 35%. And Mr. Speaker, there's nothing we can do because it will collude with National Assembly. And they pass, Mr. Speaker, whatever, if it is 20, 15, or 18%, Mr. Speaker, and there is nothing we can do. The courts have already recognized that, Mr. Speaker, appropriation will not take place at the national government level until, Mr. Speaker, we agree on division of revenue. That is why those people have run to the BBI report to remove our responsibility on division of revenue. Mr. Speaker, that report ought to be opened. And I want to challenge this House. Mr. Speaker, and particularly, and I can say this without fear of contradiction, it's a pity that, Mr. Speaker, BBI was led by a chairman who is the chair of security in this House. And, Mr. Speaker, the former Attorney General was sitting there, Mr. Speaker, who is a very respectable person. Then, Mr. Speaker, the institution that has been assaulted most is the Senate. Mr. Speaker, as a House, you must lead us to a proper retreat. And I want to thank Senator Mogheni, because I have information that in a forum, Mr. Speaker, in Naivasha, he stood firm with some of the senators there and said, things must change in this BBI report concerning the Senate. And I want to say, it will take the courage of senators in this House to stand firm and say, we want a Senate that stands for the interests of the people of Kenya. Mr. Speaker, I will hate the day I will come back to this House to be called the male Senator of Elgeyo Marakwet. I will hate the day, Mr. Speaker, I'll come to this House and call Orengo, Mr. Orengo, the male Senator of Siaya. Mr. Speaker, or call Amos Wako, the male Senator of Siaya. What kind of a thing is that? If, Mr. Speaker, we are tired of making Senate a proper Senate with, Mr. Speaker, the proper representation and one vote for every count, and we want to donate this House for purpose of gender parity, Mr. Speaker, it's better to change that section and say the Senate shall be composed of women only, so that at least every count can elect one senator who is a lady. But to come and call Senator Fatuma here that the female Senator of Isiolo, Mr. Speaker, I think we have a problem. We need, Mr. Speaker, to ensure that the institution of the Senate is protected, and we must achieve the gender rule that we must achieve, but not by, Mr. Speaker, losing the gains that we have achieved for the last 7 years or eight or so, Mr. Speaker, protecting the interest of the counties and the county government. Mr. Speaker, I thank you very much, and Mr. Speaker, please stand firm like that. Even the way you are reading the communication today, that kind of confidence is what we want. And Mr. Speaker, because these decisions for the remaining 1.5 years will be on your shoulders, Mr. Speaker. We will stand before you. We will support you like we did in this case. And, Mr. Speaker, I pray that you will stand firm. And, Mr. Speaker, I beg to support.